All right, you guys. So here's the pre-draft interviews. Let's see what these guys want from me.
Based on your performance tonight with our first round pick, 11th overall, we'd like to get to know you a little better before committing to you. I'm sure you understand. We have a couple of questions, if you don't mind. This team has a lot of momentum right now. We went through a rough stretch and had some recent draft picks that didn't work out. With guys like Monte, Stephen Curry, and David Lee, we really feel like we're on the up and up. We like what we've seen out of you, but how do you see yourself fitting in with the team?
You know, I would have wanted to go to this team, but the stadium, man, it's too bright.
You got some great young players on your roster, but I got to keep it real here, man. I really don't see it working out between me and you. I'm looking to jump into a winning situation, and you guys in Oakland don't exactly have a history of that. It's nothing personal. I just need to do me, baby. Know what I mean?
Well, I can see that we are not a match, unfortunately. Good luck to you on draft night.
All right, so these guys are out of the picture.
Nice job out there tonight. Your play really impressed us, so much so that we're considering using our pick on you if you're available when our turn comes up. Before we get that far, we'd really like to ask you a couple of questions. Question number one. We realize that here in Milwaukee, we don't have the appeal of a Los Angeles or a New York or a Miami. We tend to look for players who would be proud to be part of this organization. Someone who can really take pride in being a Milwaukee Buck. Someone who's willing to spend their entire career as a Milwaukee Buck. Are you that person?
I'd be honored to be a member of this organization. From everything I've heard, you guys have a rabid fan base up there that's ready for some postseason success. I'd love to be the guy that leads that charge.
I've heard all I needed to hear for now. You're definitely someone we can use on our team. Now we just need you to be available when it's our turn to pick.
Here's another team that I want to go to.
Hello, nice to meet you. I'm the Director of Player Personnel for the Utah Jazz. My scouts have expressed a lot of interest in you. Before I can give my blessing to use our draft pick on you, I'd like to ask you a couple of questions, you know, to make sure you'd fit in with what we do here. What do you think you'll bring to a franchise as far as marketability?
I try to answer X, but I accidentally hit the A button, so this sounds kind of corny.
Bring a smile, a hard work ethic, and some really bad dance moves, man. I feel like people can really relate to me, really get behind me, feel me?
A little disappointing, to be honest, but I appreciate you being up front with us.
Here we are, moment of truth, and a team that I kind of don't want to go to. I mean, I don't mind going to Golden State, but it's the fact that every home game I play, it's going to be that bright yellow stadium. So I'm projected to go 11th right before Klay Thompson, but usually these aren't really accurate. You're always, you know, either one pick ahead or one pick below. So I might either go 10th, I might go 12th. You never know, I might go 15th. So these are what they're going to be projecting. And again, my performance compared to Klay Thompson, not even close. I did way better, but I'm still 11th, so we're just going to have to see what happens. And, you know, same old, same old. Only difference is Brandon Knight's not going to the Pistons. John Vesely's going to the Wizards. Nick Brown, I don't think Cleveland got him. Irving, obviously the first three picks are the same. So let's start this.
Good evening and welcome to the 2011 NBA Draft. Tonight we celebrate a new class of basketball talent that has made its way to the NBA. Their dedication and hard work and that of their families has paid off, and this moment is the next step in their promising young careers. It is also a time of extraordinary optimism and hope for the fans of our teams as they look for yet additional great players to make their teams better. The selections that are made tonight will be viewed by millions of NBA fans around the world in more than 200 countries as they make their way to become NBA players. Everyone is ready, so let's get started. With the first pick in the 2011 NBA Draft, the Cleveland Cavaliers select Kyrie Irving from Duke University.
So pretty much the first eight picks, no surprise whatsoever. Kemba Walker does go ninth, so let's see who the Milwaukee Bucks are going to be selecting.
In the 2011 NBA Draft, the Milwaukee Bucks select the small forward from the University of Maryland.
So there you have it. The guy can't even say my name, but I am headed to Milwaukee, pairing up with one of the, you know, elite backcourts. You got Monte Ellis and Brandon Jennings. So I'm pretty excited, and we are headed to Milwaukee. So as far as contract negotiations, obviously your rookie year, you have no power whatsoever. I'm going to be making $1.92 million, and it's going to pretty much last me 2 years. And after the second year, it's going to be an option. The team could either let me go or pretty much keep me on the roster. So here's obviously the first endorsement that you get, the introduction billboard. The first billboard that will be going up in Milwaukee featuring my guy, The Future Has Arrived. So after my draft day, I do the usual accessory changing. You know, I gave him one sleeve, and also shoe shopping wise, we went and decided to go and get the LeBron 9s, the Ohio State colors. The gray part doesn't really go with the color scheme, but I really like the red part. So it's going to look really nice with the uniform, and we're going to be rocking that number 11. Now, before I made my season debut, I had a dream after taking a nap, and I saw this happening. Me dunking all over Tim Duncan or Tony Parker, whatever you want to say. I mean, kind of got Tony Parker right there. So that was my dream. After I woke up from that little nap, I decided to go ahead and hit the gym, work on my dribbling. I decided to hit this dribbling course right here to upgrade not only my speed, but also quickness. So hoping that this will definitely improve my guy as he makes his season debut. So here I am, just about finishing this drill right here. I got a gold, so that's definitely going to give me 400 skill points and plus one as far as my quickness goes. Now, the next drill that I did was the shooting drill, and this one I struggled in a lot. Although I got silver, I got 400 skill points, I was not shooting well at all. So it's time to make my debut here in San Antonio.
That necessary presence down low. Then it's Mbamute Mute and it's Ilya Silva in at the four-man position. And looking at the Spurs, Parker and Manu are the backcourt. He's got Duncan. He is certainly a stabilizer for him. They count on his...
Or so I come in the game with 4:19 remaining. I force a shot here, but I get my mid-range shot to go down. So my first shot in my career, first attempt goes down. Now next play right here, Brandon Jennings is taking it inside, dishes it to Udrich, and Beno Udrich looking at me, doesn't even give me the ball. He dishes it out to Ilya Sova. Finally, Ilya Sova gives me a chance here. Steven Jackson all over me. I see Gooden cutting in, and I get my first assist in the NBA. So more action coming in here with 2 minutes remaining in the second quarter. Leonard with the ball. He gets stripped. You know, I'm going to be running on Monte Ellis right here. Gives me the ball, and I do a windmill right here on Boris Diaw. First dunk in the NBA, and it doesn't get any better than this. So, still 2 minutes remaining. Drew Gooden steals the ball. I'm running here. Leonard on me, but I still get the shot to go down. And he is hurt. So, we simulate now. And I check back in. 4 minutes and 10 seconds remaining here. A pretty close game. Milwaukee is up by 2 points. And San Antonio, you know, trying to do everything they can here. I dish it out to Ilya Sova. Or should I say Dunleavy? They left him wide open. He gets his three-pointer to go down. And next possession right now, it's only a four-point game. I give it to Brandon Jennings. Jennings nowhere to go. Gives it right back to me. Pump faking my way. Post up Leonard. I notice Drew Gooden on the inside, and he is automatic. Gives me another assist. Now Tony Parker, with only a minute 40 to work with, gives it to Ginobili, and I make a mistake of leaving him wide open. So San Antonio cuts it to 3 points here. Ilya Sova gives me a nice pick. I take it inside, do a Jordan classic dunk, and I am just kissing the guns right here, showboating the fans as I get a dunk right here and one. So I head to the free throw line to convert my and one, and I do. So late in the game, I come up big for my team. So now it's only a 2-point game. Brandon Jennings with the ball. And here with 30 seconds remaining, he takes it inside, nowhere to go, gives it to Gooden. Gooden inside move. He gets that shot to go down, so it's a four-point game. What will San Antonio do here on the other way? Brandon Jennings playing good defense, and Ginobili, or should I say Tony Parker, loses the ball. I get it right here, and I get that layup to go down. So now for the San Antonio Spurs, it's too little, too late. Although Ginobili gets that shot to go down, we come up big here in the fourth quarter, get a four-point victory. Not only do I do good as a team, but I also do good individually as well. So we pick up our victory here in my season debut against the San Antonio Spurs. And also, as far as my objective goes, I completed all of them. So you know what that means, getting a lot of skill points here. And it's also a key game, so multiply that by two.
Just played your first official NBA game. Did things go as you expected?
Yeah, I think so. I was pretty happy with the way I played. You know, at this point, I'm still just getting used to my role on the team and, you know, doing everything I can to learn from the guys who've been here longer than me. I hope this was only the beginning of what will be a long career ahead of me, you feel me?
So like always, your first ever endorsement is the welcome letter. And this is from Jordan, pretty much telling you that he has his eye on you. And pretty soon, I'm going to be getting an endorsement from him. So here is how my schedule looks. First game, we played San Antonio. Next up, we play in Charlotte before we make our home opener against New York. So that is it, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I'll be back pretty shortly. Chase the kids, and I got the Patricks. Number one.